Hey, welcome back to another episode of Fishing Is My Summer Job. This episode, I traveled north to my parents' place up at Higgins Lake. Did a little bit of perch rock bass fishing. And the main reason for the trip up there, besides doing my dad's floor that he was fixing, was a little hex fix fishing. So, night one, and it's really hard to get video because it's dark, but night one, I got a few nice ones. This next fish, this is the nicest one of the night, and then also landed a little 14-incher. It was a lot of fun, a lot of flies, a lot of fish. It was a lot of fun fishing with my family, my nephew Nikita, my brother Doug. My dad fished. Arena even had her fishing pole in the lake for a little bit. My mom was along for the ride. We had a great time out on the lake. It got a little windy coming back in, but it all was made better when we got to have a fish fry afterwards. Now this next video is from our third night. Second night, it's kind of weird, just where there was nothing going on. There were no flies at all in the water. The temps were good. Everything else looked good unless they went way later than we stayed. Here's night three, just a little shot of what we were watching for. I ended up getting a nice brook trout. And then I was just searching and I stumbled onto a couple of nice browns. Like as you can see, nice fish. It was a lot of fun. And then the next night, I was up there repairing my boat too, because I had a little problem with it after the last time I went smallmouth fishing. Got that patched. We thought we'd give it a test out. So we're throwing some dries here early part in the float. We got some small trout. It was a lot of fun. We were hoping there'd be some hex, or if not, we'd get a streamer bite. My other rod is rigged up with a streamer at this point. And there were a lot of rises going on, so I switched up. And I've never drifted this part of the Asabo River before. There was a few overhanging branches. I made some of this a little bit challenging. We finished up in the dark. I flipped my boat. I lost the tackle box and my net. If you're up there between Stephen Bridge and Wakey Bridge and you find a nice measure net and a tackle box full of mice and some other streamers, hey, that's mine. Probably won't be any good after a few more days. You know how that goes with the rust and all. But got a nice little mix here. I landed, I think, four or five browns. I think I got two browns and a rainbow on the film. But it was overall a really good time. Yeah, I really enjoyed floating this stretch. I think if I'm going to do it again, I'm going to take the boat and just float from areas where they're feeding to areas where they're feeding, and then park the boat and jump out and fish them. We'd never done this before, so we were taking a look, and it was some great cover in here.
Hey, a rainbow, Doug.
It wasn't all wilderness. Some of it was manicured yards,
yeah,
million-dollar homes. But we had enough of the wilds, and there were trout right in around where the homes are at too. So I will go back. I really enjoyed floating this section. So here we go. This is the final fish that I got on film. Again, nothing big on this one. I wish I could have got the browns on. The ones I landed were really nice, about 18, 19 inches, and I lost one big one. I don't know, that big one really came up in that. It was actually the first fish I caught on the first night. It hit, and then it ran me downstream a ways, and then it like pulled its head up and just shook its head till the fly came out at the surface. And I've never seen one do that. Usually they'll come up and jump, or they'll run you towards wood. You know, if you've ever hooked a brown, you know, the first thing they're going to do is to run you for a log. But it didn't either. And it was kind of an interesting way that one fought. Maybe I hooked it in a weird spot too. I've noticed sometimes with bass, if you hook smallmouth in the lower jaw, they're going in the air for sure. If you hook them in the upper jaw, they'll pull you down and pull. Kind of just the way the hook, I think, puts pressure into them. But as you can see, another pretty little brown. Hopefully this one grows up and becomes one of those big 20-inchers, you know, that we all like to catch. Well, once again, I want to thank you for tuning in. I'm not sure what I'm going to have for my next episode. We're in the middle of a big cold front right now, so we'll see what's biting. So thanks for tuning in. Remember, fishing is my summer job.